morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. I was deliberating last night how best to frame the overarching subject matter of this panel to reflect the remarks of all the speakers who will be presenting today. And while many of them will be talking about certainly man and certainly machine, I think there's a broader theme here, which is how can we get the emerging technologies of the next era accepted by the general public and implemented within everyday life. This is why I chose the title Advocating for the Future, to unite all of the remarks of our speakers today. And one vehicle that we are going to have increasingly over the coming years to advocate for the future is the United States Transhumanist Party. And I would like to tell you a bit about how we are pursuing a peaceful political revolution for longevity. The mission of the Transhumanist Party is putting science, health, and technology at the forefront of American politics. Consideration of these issues is sorely lacking in American politics today. Now, the Transhumanist Party is going to turn 3 years old this year. One of our panelists, Zoltan Isfahan, was the founder of the Transhumanist Party on October 7th, 2014. Later today, he will tell you about his remarkable immortality bus tour and his run for president in 2016. I will tell you a bit about what happened after. On November 17th, 2016, Zoltan decided to designate me as his successor, as chairman of the U.S. Transhumanist Party. And in that role, I have strived to turn the Transhumanist Party into a member-driven organization, a hub for the transhumanist and life extensionist movements. We would like to recruit as many individuals as possible who are interested in thinking about the future and improving the human condition as members who will suggest policy ideas, who will deliberate over them, who will vote on them. And accordingly, we have the lowest possible barriers to entry for membership. Membership is absolutely free and always will be. You can go to our website at www.transhumanist-party.org, fill out a simple application form, and join the over 550 people who have become members thus far. During my tenure, I hope to increase that number to at least 10,000. So let's start today. So far, we have conducted 6 sessions of online voting just this year. And keep in mind, no matter what your other political persuasions, we welcome you. We are transhumanists, we are also transpartisan. We have members who identify as libertarians, socialists, Democrats, Republicans, centrists, apolitical, or others who wouldn't fit any of those categories. We welcome all of them. We have also acquired a distinguished set of advisors, many of whom are here today, Dr. Bill Andrews, Dr. Jose Cordero, Dr. Giovanni Santastasi, Dr. Aubrey de Grey, and of course, Zoltan Isfahan, our political and media advisor. We are so honored to have all of their insights and input. Now, what do you need to do in order to be eligible to vote in our internal elections of the Transhumanist Party? All you need to do is agree to 3 core ideals which were framed to be as broad and inclusive as possible, accommodating various definitions of what it might mean to be a transhumanist. But I think all transhumanists will broadly share these sentiments. Ideal number 1 is that the Transhumanist Party supports significant life extension achieved through the progress of science and technology. Ideal number 2 is that the Transhumanist Party supports a cultural, societal, and political atmosphere informed and animated by reason, science, and secular values. And I will add, secular values do not mean a hostility to religion or even an absence of religion for some individuals. They simply mean religion should not be used as the basis to set government policy and constrain how individuals lead their lives. But if you are a religious person and you support life extension and you support the emerging technologies of the future, we welcome you as well. And ideal number 3 is that the Transhumanist Party supports efforts to use science, technology, and rational discourse to reduce and eliminate various existential risks to the human species. And Some of these existential risks exist without technology, like an asteroid impact striking the Earth. Other existential risks may arise from earlier generations of technology. Think of the risk of nuclear warfare. But technology, I think, guided by reason and morality, is the solution to these existential risks as well. But these emerging technologies that are on the horizon, some of which have already entered our society, need advocates in order for us to transition to the next era of human civilization. We have technologies of genetic engineering, nanotechnology, biotechnology, which can converge to procure radical life extension for hopefully as many of us as possible. We have technologies of artificial intelligence, which Dr. Ben Goertzel will be discussing today. We have space colonization, which might enable us to become a multiplanetary species and reduce the existential risks that might befall us if we put all our eggs in one basket, which is planet Earth. We have the possibility of seasteading, modular ocean communities that can be used as experiments in governments. We have the possibility of vertical farming, which could massively increase the available arable land. We have possibilities for economical alternative energy, ranging from solar to geothermal to nuclear. We can dramatically automate production to allow for radical abundance, cheaper goods for as many people as possible. Autonomous electric and flying cars can both save lives and improve convenience and give us back a lot of our time. Augmented reality, virtual reality could open up new worlds. Encryption could help us protect our privacy. Technologies of the blockchain, cryptocurrencies, smart contracts, DAOs, distributed autonomous organizations, companies that essentially run themselves, and ectogenesis, artificial wombs. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we lived in a world where all of these technologies were as broadly available as possible? That is our mission. But the political system today poses many obstacles. We have seen in the 2016 elections the ugly political rhetoric that reiterates centuries-old fallacies that appeal to the lowest common denominator. Major fallacies like the fear of technology and trade taking jobs. Fallacies that pit some groups of people needlessly against others. We would like to change that. We would like to see candidates who are thoughtful, creative, and forward-thinking in discussing not just the issues of the day, but the future that Americans will face for decades and centuries to come. But the biggest obstacle to that kind of vision today is the two-party system in the United States. This system, which has built up tremendous barriers to participation by individuals of innovative perspectives. Extremely high ballot access laws in many states where you have to get thousands of hand-signed petitions just to get your party onto the ballot. Controlled by the two parties of the Commission on Presidential Debates, which precluded even popular candidates like Gary Johnson and Jill Stein from bringing their views to a mass audience. Non-inclusive polling that doesn't represent many of the perspectives that are out there. And the pernicious mentality cultivated by the two parties within the general public of the wasted vote, the idea that if you don't vote for the candidate you consider the lesser evil, then you're just throwing your vote away. I say you're throwing your vote away if you vote for something you don't believe in. So this system does not represent the interests of genuine human flourishing or well-being. It does not represent a constructive approach toward solving problems. We can do better. Transhumanist politics is different because we reject the zero-sum mentality that today competing special interest groups use to suggest that in order for them to win, others must lose. No, transhumanism seeks to overcome the present mindset of scarcity and bring about a future of widespread abundance. The biggest scarcity we need to overcome is the scarcity of time that we currently face with our miserably short lifespans. What could you do if instead of a few decades, you had a few centuries, a few millennia to look forward to? No expiration date at all. Let's bring that future about. And we know from a study of economics and of moral philosophy, people who are more prosperous, more comfortable, more fulfilled in their lives are less likely to react with vicious hostility toward others. We want to transform politics into what it should always have been, which is a constructive focus on which policies are best for improving human well-being and solving the problems that confront us. So we do a lot of things differently in order to achieve that. We have our free, open membership. You don't even have to be eligible to vote in the United States to become an allied member. You can still help us in our internal deliberations, participate on our discussion boards, provide suggestions for our platform, write articles, write position statements. We are transpartisan. We embrace all thinkers who can constructively shape a future of radical human flourishing. Most political parties today bring a message of fear. You should be afraid of something of people, some set of events, something in your life. We are the party of hope. And I would contend we also transcend the old dichotomy between left and right. The new dichotomy is open versus closed, or as the great proto-transhumanist thinker F.M. 2030 put it, upwing versus downwing. As the author Virginia Postrel posited in The Future and Its Enemies, it is a dynamist versus stasis dichotomy. But there is a relative vacuum today in the open, upwing, and dynamist policy space, and that is the vacuum that the transhumanist party seeks to fill. Mainstream politics currently almost completely neglects the crucial role of technology in shaping the possibilities of everyday life. And we wish to change that, combining technological advocacy with freedom, tolerance, and cosmopolitanism, because those values are the preconditions on which continued technological progress depends. I encourage you to look up the Transhumanist Bill of Rights version 2.0, a greatly expanded version from the one Zoltan delivered to the U.S. Capitol in 2015. We had a ranked preference vote on it in December of 2016, and the original 6 articles expanded to 25. We have an extensive new preamble now that discusses what it means to be a sentient entity, because in the future, the rights articulated in this document will not just be limited to human beings. We might have sentient artificial general intelligences, or uplifted animals, or if we come into contact with other rational extraterrestrial beings, we should think now about how we should interact with these entities in a manner that respects their rights. And we have 6 articles specifically supporting life extension in the Transhumanist Bill of Rights. I would also encourage you to read our platform, which is Article 3 of the U.S. Transhumanist Party Constitution. So far, we have 63 planks. It's a very thorough, thoughtful document based on the deliberations and contributions of our members. We have had 5 voting periods over the course of the past half year using the ranked preference method, which enables people not only to select their most preferred option, but to rank order all of the options that are available. So in the instant runoff process, if their top choice gets eliminated, they still have an influence in subsequent rounds. We have 3 planks in our platform so far that also specifically support life extension, and you can help spread our platform by writing articles about our planks, writing more detailed position statements and in-depth analyses, and please bring your own perspectives, bring your own opinions to it, because we want to start a discussion among anybody who cares about creating a better future. And finally, I would encourage you again to go on our website, go to the top bar of links, navigate to become a member. It is a quick, simple application form that you can fill out. Please feel free to approach me at any time if you should have any questions, either here at RadFest or via my email address.